So I got this Bear Grizzly off eBay. Nice vintage Bear Grizzly from the 70s. Only thing I didn't like was a little sight rail. But I was like, whatever, it's just two little holes. And it's actually kind of cool green. Maybe I'll just leave it, do something weird there. Get a camera mount, who knows. And it was like 45 pounds, 58 inch grizzly. I was like, this is so perfect. It has the green I wanted in it. And it's pretty, it's really cool because it's like two-tone. And the limb tips are like nice and green. Seller offered a discount. Took it, received it in the mail, and he shipped it with the string on. Yeah, sucks. So I got a refund. I have a bow now that is cracked, and of course I'm gonna try to fix it. So watched some videos, thought about it for a few days, and just thought recently tonight of using a two-step process of wood glue for the internal part of the limb and super glue on the outside. Not just super glue, the super glue and baking soda trick. So let's give that a shot. Got this Loctite super gel. Got the external fiberglass fitted as best I could. The cracks put back into place. My plan is to completely soak inside and outside the fiberglass with the Loctite super gel and then squeeze it to make sure like it's under compression and flat. And then dump a bunch of baking soda right on top of it. So, thinking it's gonna be a two-handed process, so maybe I'll just have the limb resting right here and I'll push down with just one finger so I can take my other hand and dump the baking soda on top of it. Here we go. This gel wasn't the best to use. I thought it was gonna be more watery. Or viscous, I should say. I sand all that after a nice coating of super glue, crazy glue, and baking soda. So the outside limb is intact, or the fiberglass, to say. It's not bad. Let's move on to filling this with wood glue now, and then we'll clamp this all down. Gonna go grab another C clamp, but just to show you the setup for now. I'm gonna have to sit for at least 24 hours. And go back in, clean off all the glue excess. And also sand down the sand down and polish and finish the Loctite baking soda. While we're at it, let's remove this corrosion. So I was trying to date this grizzly, and I toughened catalogs. I found online that it is after 1970 or 71 or 72, but then by the medallion, because it has that green corrosion on it, it has copper in it, so it could either be the copper or nickel medallion, because nickel has copper in the alloy. So, but I just want to clean that off. That's just driving me crazy. That's like a copper coin to me. Being finicky, I can't see this. Thank you.